Good morning, Key Stage 1 and Earliers, and welcome to our second ever online Friday assembly. Like last week, I'm going to hand straight over to some of your teachers who have some very special messages.
Good morning, children. How are you? I have really missed your beautiful and handsome faces. I have missed your beautiful and vibrant smiles. I hope you're keeping safe. I hope you're enjoying doing your work at home. Now for this week's Star of the Week, we have two children from Year 2 Silver. The first one is Mihir Patel. Well done, Mihir Patel. You have been doing fantastic work over the week. Your handwriting has been good. You've used adjectives in your writing. You have been remembering to punctuate your sentences. I am really, really impressed with the quality of your work. So keep up the good work. Very, very proud of you. Our second Star of the Week from Year 2 Silver is Burhanuddin Ali Bhai. Now, Burhanuddin Ali Bhai has been very consistent when it comes to projects. He's always going out of his way to make sure his work is nicely done. He's working very hard on his handwriting and his spelling, and he's putting good effort into all his assignments. So I'm very, very proud of you, Burhanuddin Ali Bhai. Keep up the good work and keep up keep working hard on all your tasks. I am hoping to see you guys soon. Keep up the positive energy. Keep staying safe. I hope to see you guys soon. Keep working hard, and I'm really, really proud of all of you. See you soon. Bye-bye.
Good morning, everyone, people. I hope you had a fantastic week. Before I start, I would like to say happy birthday to Brian and Abasali for turning 6 years. And Abasali, I hope you also bake us a cake when you open schools. Back to Star of the Week. You guys, this week you have been amazing. I really loved your poems. I didn't know you were great poets like that. And as you can see, Year 1 people, we are all stars. It's full of stars. So it was hard for me to decide who to pick. But then I have to pick one or two. So I'm first going to pick one person who has improved greatly in his work. And it's Aaron. Well done, Aaron. Keep it up. And the next Star of the Week, this one, I really enjoyed the videos that he sent. They made me laugh, especially the one with the papaya when he was singing the song and dancing. Well done. So the Star of the Week goes to Jonathan. Well done, Jonathan. Well done, Aaron. Keep it up, guys. I miss you all and I love you. Stay safe.
Well done to everyone who's been mentioned so far, but before we hear from the rest of your teachers, I'm going to hand over to Miss Sabibi, who has a story for us.
Good morning, everybody. I hope you've had a lovely week and done lots and lots of learning. I know your teachers have been working really, really hard to set you some fun work to do. So today, I've got a special story for Assembly. It's Pizzas for Pirates. Who likes pizza? I like pizza. Who loves pizza? I'm sure there's lots of you out there, and who doesn't like pizza? Is there anybody? Let's read the story. A boy called George had a wonderful plan to sail with a fine pirate crew. So he packed up a pizza, his favourite feast, and rowed off on the wide ocean blue. George travelled for hours till he spotted dry land and saw mermaids on rocks from afar. As he steered into port, he heard pieces of eight and a loud croaky voice roaring, "Arr!" "Ahoy there," cried George, and he held up his sword. "Please can I be a pirate like you?" But all he heard was a flap and a screech. Then a noisy bird burst into view. "I'm a parrot," it squawked as it perched on his head. "And pirates love parrots, I'm told. I'll help you to track down a whole pirate crew and we'll find treasure chests full of gold." George steered his boat on through the choppy green waves as a shiver of sharks glided by. Then he spotted a shape in the mist up ahead, so he popped a patch over his eye. "Is it a pirate ship?" George asked the bird. The parrot screeched, "Where is its sail?" George peered through the telescope and gave a cry. That's not pirate ship. Look, it's a whale. They tried to escape from the whale's gaping mouth, but a whale struck the boat in its jaws. With a whoosh, George was swallowed. How would he escape? It even lost one of his oars. Oh, look. George switched on his torch and he looked all about while the parrot flew down with a flap. Shiver me timbers, cried George when he saw a hat and an old treasure map. As he put on the pirate hat, George told the bird, get back in the boat, I've a plan. Think of the best pirate joke that you know and then squawk it as loud as you can. Do you know any pirate jokes? Why are pirates called pirates? Because they are. When the bird told the joke, a strange sound could be heard. First a rumble and then a loud roar. The whale's laughing, said George with a sigh of relief. Then he paddled like mad with his oar. Achoo! They shot out of the mouth of the chuckling whale and splashed through the waves and the spray till the parrot called out, land ahoy, George, me lad, and they steered the boat into a bay. George stepped onto the sand, then he crept up the beach while above him his parrot friend flew, and the sound of a loud voices peered through the trees and saw there a real pirate crew. Avast there, me hearties, called George with a wave. Please can I be a pirate like you? Then he held out a dripping wet box and announced, I brought pizza for the whole crew. The captain, square matey, you seem a fine lad, but that thing you call pizza looks yuck. Then he gasped and he stared down at George's wet head. You found my best hat, we're in luck. Is my treasure map with it? The captain asked George. I lost them both long, long ago. Yes, it is, exclaimed George, and he held up the map. Then he read it and shouted, let's go. They walked this way and that till George came to a stop. It's here, he said. Dig, no one rest. The shipmates worked hard in the burning hot sun till they dug up. Can you see it? A huge treasure chest. But while the pirates grabbed handfuls of gold, a green tentacle crept onto the beach. Sea monster suddenly burst from the depths and carried the chest out of reach. It lifted the treasure towards its huge mouth. George shouted, stop, listen to me. Eat this pizza instead. You can have the whole thing. It's much tastier than treasure, you'll see. The monster glared down at the dripping wet snack. Then it gobbled it up in one bite. It put down the chair and the crew roared, George, lad, you're the best kind of pirate, all right. Then the captain said, George, now you're one of the crew. There is just one more thing to be done. We must head for our ship and then you'll walk the plank. And then we'll show you how pirates have fun. The end. I hope you've enjoyed listening to the story. Bye, everybody.
Thank you for a lovely story, Mrs. Sabibi. Next, we're going to go back to some more messages from your teachers.
Morning reception. Morning, Key Stage 1.
Good morning.
I've got somebody who'd like to say hello.
Hello. How are you?
We're missing you lots.
Yeah.
And I hope you've had a good week. I'm just going to show you some work that's made me really proud. And the star of the week for reception green is, let me see if you can guess. So the star of the week is, I wonder if she turns on, if she can tell. I love all the work she's done from tallest to shortest, and using all her toys and things around her with the help of her family. Our star of the week is Glory. Well done, Glory. It's good to see you using all your toys and getting the help of your family to help you find the tallest and shortest. Well done. I hope you have a good week.
Hi. Good morning, Joanna Ringe. How are you? I hope you're still staying safe. I miss you so much. Well, today I want to thank everybody for working so hard in submitting their work. Not just submitting the work, but for working so hard in making incredible sentences, doing amazing in math, your calculations, doing writing rhymes, and doing sending videos, and really, really doing amazing work. So, today is which day? Friday. What do we do on Friday? Today is a birthday star of the week. Yeah, it's a time of giving star of the week. And our first star of the week is Rudra. Rudra, you get your star of the week for your incredible improvement in your writing and writing full sentences. Well done, Rudra. Well done. Hooray. And I know what you're guessing. Yep, we got two star of the week. Our second star of the week is Louisa. Louisa gets her star of the week for trying her best, working hard all week, and for submitting awesome videos. Well done, Louisa. Yay! Hooray, Louisa. Well, from Miss Kathomi to my lovely one oranges, I'm sending you big, big hugs and saying I love you so much and I miss you and I hope to see you soon. Bye.
Hello. Good morning. How are you? Hope you're all doing fine and having a great day. It has been quite a busy week and I know you have all been working very, very hard. And I would like to congratulate all of you to God for participating and working very hard in all the activities that they have been assigned to. Today and this week, we are going to have three stars of the week. And the first star of the week is going to be Lawi. Has worked very hard and he is the star of the week for great improvement in his grammar and sentence construction. Well done, Lawi. The second star of the week is going to be Burhanuddin. Burhanuddin Hakimji has been working very hard as well, and I'm very impressed of him applying and using his joint handwriting whenever he writes his sentences and all of his work. The third person who is going to be the star of the week is going to be Rosabella. Well done, Rosabella. Rosabella has been working very hard. She has a great improvement in her grammar and uses of tenses, and she has also been working hard and trying to submit her work. Thank you and well done, everyone. I'm very proud of your hard working. Keep it up. I'm still looking forward for you to work harder and harder. Well done. See you. Bye.
And now I'm cutting back in between the messages from our teachers, because some of you may have seen, I asked you to do a job for me this week. I asked, with all the reading we're doing on EPIC, over 2,250 books we have read now, it becomes very hard to know what to read next. So some of you have been submitting your book reviews to me. So now let's see what some of you are recommending to read.
Hello everybody, I recommend this book about pugs. I like this book because it tells you where pugs came from and how to look after them. They have lots of cute pictures and there are lots of other books that have dogs that are really good. Thank you, bye!
Guys, I read about a book about a superhero called Batman. You can search it on Epic. It's nice, please read it for me. Thank you.
And I have been reading Under Sea Mystery Club. And I think it's a nice book.
Good morning, everyone. Hello, Preschool One. It's a lovely day today to show your work, what you've been doing. And moms and dads, I would like to say thank you so much for working very hard with the children at home. And I'll be trying my best to send as much work as I can on that you may see what your children are doing. So I appreciate so much your work and I would like to say thank you. Enjoy seeing your children's work.
This week, we have been working on number color code and this is work done by Maya. She has done very well concentrated work using the appropriate colors. Well done, Maya. Thank you for supporting Maya at home, parents. Here we see Joella working very hard at home doing her work. Well done, Joella. Really concentrating. Keep it up. With all that concentration, now we can see the finished piece of work of Joella, and she is very happy too, I believe, with their work. Therefore, our Star of the Week certificates today, they go to Joella and Maya. Well done, girls. You have really done well your work. I'm so pleased. You really concentrated on the number color code. Keep it up, girls. Thank you, moms and dads, for working at home with the children. We love them so much and we miss them. Well done for your support at home. Thank you.
Morning reception, Red. I just wanted to show you some wonderful work that you've been doing. So this is Abraham's number line work. I'm glad to see that he's using a number line to help him with addition. This is Shirusti's writing. Good to see that she's using full stops and capital letters. This is her lovely, beautiful moon and crescent for Eid and her English work. It's Graceland's math and Graceland's sentence writing. So our star of the week is... Abraham Mata for his wonderful addition using the number line. I'm glad to see that he's got better using the number line. So well done, Abraham Mata. You're the star of the week for Reception Red.
Hello everybody. So in preschool too, I have seen lots and lots of really fantastic work coming in. It's great to see that most of you now are sending stuff online to me. And it's been really, really hard to think who am I going to give Star of the Week to this week. But this week it goes to Anaya and Eric. Well done, you two. Bye.
And now it is time for us to sing some songs. So like last week, I will cut some videos. I will make sure they have the words at the bottom. Sing loud and join in at home.
Spider went up the water.
And that is the end of our assembly for this week. Remember, next week we are not at school on Monday and Tuesday. Lots of you will be celebrating Eid with your families. Your teachers will be very busy writing your reports. So you will be back onto online learning on Wednesday. So enjoy the long weekend with your families at home. Make sure you're getting some time to relax. Keep reading on Epic. We've got a huge amount of books being read now. But enjoy your families. Enjoy your time. Keep safe. And we will see you next week for our Friday assembly. Bye.